Hey, today we're going to talk about Sidney Crosby and the return of Sid the Kid to the Pittsburgh Penguins. Not Crosby per se. Hey, his owners don't need me to tell them what adding a point and a half player a game to their lineup is going to do at this stage of the season. But rather, I think we're going to look at the impact he's going to have on the players around him. For starters, I think you have to look at Pascal Dupuis, his regular right winger. Pascal Dupuis is having a pretty good year, 14 points before Sid came in. But those three assists he got in the Islanders game, their reunion game, so to speak, you're going to see his fantasy impact spike up. And if he happens to be available in your league, he's not going to be far after this weekend. Wish we could say the same thing about Kritz Kunitz's left winger. Kunitz is going to get the same benefit playing even strength with Crosby, but Crosby was the one who took his place on the first power play team. Speaking of the first power play team, that unit did look pretty good against the Islanders, didn't it? Crosby and Malkin playing on the same ice, so I think now you have to look at Steve Sullivan, James Neal, defenseman Chris Letang. Their fantasy value is going to spike as well because of this. Yeah, I think you also have to look at goalie Marc-Andre Fleury. He's going to get some more wins out of this and maybe even a better goals against average, really for the simple reason that having Crosby on the ice controlling the puck and the play, it's going to be pretty hard to score against him. Lastly, I think the only guy who may be hurt by the return of Sidney Crosby could be Jordan Staal. He drops down to the number three center role, and although he is going to still stay on the second power play team. This is Joel Colnaby for the Toronto Sun.